All right, let's talk about how to convert units of measure. Maybe the concept that is used the most in any science class, because almost every single problem is going to require you to convert units in chemistry, physics, biology, kind of whatever. Converting units is a big one that never leaves once you learn it. And you'll see lots of different ways on how to convert units. And because it's kind of just using fraction math, there are lots of different ways to show it, lots of ways to draw brackets or different things to help people remember it. And the way that I'm going to go over today is kind of the longest way possible. This is the anti-shortcut way, which sounds annoying, but I think that this is the way that fundamentally explains it. And if you are struggling, and if every time you have to convert units, you just find yourself flustered and lost, and you don't know which number to pick or where to put it, this is the way that really explains that. So this is not the way that's gonna get done in like a minute, but this is the way that's going to help you understand. And even if you don't know what's happening, as long as you carefully follow all of these steps, you're going to get the right answer. So if you're just starting out or struggling, this is the way for you. And so let's start. We'll be doing our practice problem, how to convert 16 centimeters into meters. And so step one is to identify your conversion ratio. And so in every conversion problem, we're going from one unit to another, and there's always some ratio that's going to connect those two. And this is kind of how to find this is kind of more of an introduction on the metric system or something else. So we're just going to start with assuming that you know how to find your conversion ratio for this problem. And so that means that we have to know the relationship between centimeters and meters. And so that relationship is that 100 centimeters equals 1 meter. And so this is our conversion ratio. That's step one. We're done. We know that this is how centimeters and meters relate to each other. So step two, write your conversion ratio as its two possible fractions. And what I mean by that is that your equal sign is now going to become your fraction bar. And so for this, our two possible options are 100 centimeters over 1 meter, and then our other option is 1 meter over 100 centimeters. And so I made both of them because I don't know which one I'm going to need yet. All I know is that I have my conversion ratio, and this equal sign is now going to turn into a fraction where either one could be on top. So that's always what you're going to do, is just make these two different fractions with both options on top. And so now step three, draw your given number as a fraction, including units. And this is really important because every number is secretly a fraction, whether or not it shows it. And so the number that we got in the problem is just written like this, 16 centimeters. And now we're going to draw that as a fraction. And so what that means is that if there's no fraction like seen immediately, it means that this is secretly a numerator. And so if it's secretly a numerator, then when we draw it out, it's going to be like this. 16 and centimeters, very important, are both on the numerator. And then our denominator is just one. Because remember that if our denominator is one, then really what we see on the numerator, that just is our total answer. And so this step is really important, and never drop the units. All students want to drop units. It's just in their blood. Don't do it, especially in these problems. We're converting units. Make sure that you know that your centimeters is on the numerator. That's very important. Okay, great. So now that we have all of our prep work done, we're ready to do the actual problem. And so step four, pick the best conversion fraction, multiply, and solve. Okay, so for this first example, I'm just going to set everything up. So we have our 16 centimeters over 1. This is our actual number now written as a fraction. And so step one, or option one, is that we just multiply it with this guy. This is the first conversion fraction that we made. So let's just set that up. And then we have another or situation because we could multiply it with this guy. So let's set that guy up too. So it's our same number that's getting converted, 16 centimeters over 1. And now we have this second fraction, so 1 meter over 100 centimeters. All right, so one of these is going to be correct and one of these is going to be wrong. So now let's just do the math and solve. So if we multiply across the top on the numerator here, we're going to get 16 times 100. And so that's going to be 1600. And then remember, we have to multiply our numerator. So this is not going to cancel out. We have 2 centimeters on top. So that means that our answer for this will be centimeters squared. And then our ones are going to multiply. That's just going to be 1. And then our meter didn't cancel out or do anything, so that's going to be still here. So option number 1, we got 1600 centimeters squared over 1 meter. Now this is an ugly, gross answer. We don't want this. So this was the wrong choice. So now let's see what the choice was with the correct conversion fraction. So over here, we have, and this is the most important part, our cancellation. This centimeters is on top and this one's on bottom, so we can cancel them out. And so now when we multiply, it's just going to be 16 times 1. So just going to be 16. And our unit is going to be meters. And then on the bottom, it's just going to be 1 times 100. So that's just going to be 100. And there is no unit on the bottom because centimeter got canceled out. So now we have 16m over 100. And just to simplify, put it into a decimal or calculator, we get 0.16. And our unit is meter. And so this is our correct answer. And let's assume we're taking a science class. We have to do sig figs here. So our original problem had 1, 2 sig figs, just 1 for each non-zero. And then our final answer, this is not a sig fig. Both of these are. Remember that leading zeros are never sig figs. So our final answer has 2 sig figs. So that's correct. And so in these problems, our conversion ratios don't really count as sig figs. You wouldn't count any sig figs for this or this because it's considered like a perfect number. So 100 centimeters at equals 1 meter, that's not a measurement. We didn't like go into the lab and say, okay, we figured that out. That's just kind of like a perfect thing that all of science assumes. So we don't have to use sig figs from those two numbers. All right, now let's do a couple more practice problems. All right, so starting with our first problem, convert 0.685 milligrams into grams. So we're just going to do the same 4 steps and do them really diligently, and we won't get misled into a wrong answer. So step 1, identify your conversion ratio. So in this case, we're comparing milligrams and grams. And so the relationship is that 1,000 milligrams equals 1 gram. All right, and so now we're going to write our 2 possible conversion fractions. So our equal sign just literally becomes a fraction. And so it doesn't matter what you start with on top. There's only 2 options since you only have 2 things. So our 2 fraction options are 1,000 milligrams over 1 gram or 1 gram over 1,000 milligrams. All right, so one of these is going to be the conversion unit that we need. All right, so step 3, draw your given number as a fraction, including units. And so I'd pick this example because even decimals can secretly be fractions. So if you have a decimal, just use it as normal and put 0.685 and milligrams. They're all going to be on the numerator. And then you can just throw a 1 under it, and that's still completely fine. And so just be really careful. Make sure your units are still in the numerator. And so now step 4, pick the best conversion fraction, multiply and solve. So we're going to set up our original problem number. And now we have to pick what conversion fraction is going to go right here. Which one is going to help us solve. And so for that, we're going to do a little bit of thinking ahead. And our big goal here is to cancel out milligrams. The whole point of the problem is to get rid of milligrams and put it into grams. And so we can see if we put this guy in there, milligrams is going to be on the numerator, and that means that you're going to end up with something milligrams squared, and then our grams is going to be on the denominator, and that's not right. So what we don't want is to use that one. And we do want to use this guy because we can see right here, this milligrams on the bottom is going to cancel out with the milligrams that we have on top from our number. So this is the one that's going to help us out. So we can fill this in 1 gram over 1,000 mgs. All right. And so now let's do some calculator math. I don't feel like solving this right now. So we plug that in and we get 0.000685, and then our unit is grams. This cancels out, and this is our number. And so now let's again assume we're doing it in a science class, not a math class. We're gonna then have to do sig figs. And so our original problem, this doesn't count, it's a leading 0, 1, 2, 3 sig figs. So we want our final answer to have 3 sig figs. So none of these leading zeros count. 1, 2, 3. So this ended up in 3 sig figs, so this is correct. And remember that in a conversion, none of these are gonna count for sig figs. We just ignore them. The only one that was given to us, the only one that's a measurement, is this first 0.685. Okay, cool. And now let's do our last example. Convert an eighth of a liter into milliliters. All right, and so step one, identify your conversion ratio. Once again, we're just dealing with two different units, liter and milliliters. So 1 liter equals 1,000 milliliters. So our two conversion ratios and their two possible fractions are 1 liter over 1,000 mils or 1,000 mils over 1 liter. And so now we're going to draw our given number as a fraction, including units. And so once again, I gave you a different type of number to force you to think about where your units go and what happens when you convert a number into a fraction. And so this says convert an eighth of a liter. So if we just draw that out, it's going to be 1/8. And the way that you see units written next to fractions is usually like this. They're right in the middle. So 1/8 of a liter. And this is pretty typical, but it's really important to know what that actually means, because when we have to assign that unit to a part of our fraction, we have two options, right? We could do this. We could do 1 liter over 8, or we could do this, 1/8 liters. And one is correct and one is incorrect. And so the big thing to really know is that unless stated otherwise, your unit is on the numerator. So this is the correct one. We were not told here that this was the denominator. It just was kind of neutral. It's kind of hanging off to the side, but it actually means this, not this. So if we meant that it was 1/8 liters, which is completely possible, that could be in a science problem or a math problem, we would just have to be told that. It would have meant that in our original problem, that would have been shown. Okay, so now we have our step three done. And so now we're going to pick our best conversion fraction, multiply and solve. So 1 liters over 8. And I just use the parentheses because I think that they kind of make it easy to see. You don't need to be using them. And so we have our two options. And so now thinking ahead to which one is going to cancel out. So we want our liters down here because that is the only way that they're going to cancel out, right? So our most important thing is to say which conversion fraction allows us to get the liters in the denominator, because that's the way we're going to get rid of it and make room for the milliliters. And so now if we go and we look at our two different conversion fractions, the only one that has liters in the denominator is this one, which means this is the one we have to plug in. This is the one that's going to allow the correct canceling and the right answer to appear. All right, so now let's do our multiplication and do some canceling out. So if we cancel these guys out, and we know we're going to end up in mil, and so basically we have 1,000 over 8, and that turns into 125. And so that's our answer. So just to talk about sig figs a little bit in this problem. So we had it written up here as an eighth. It was just words, not numbers. And so the way that I run my classes is when you see that, it means that you don't consider sig figs, that you just consider it to be an eighth is like a perfect number, kind of like our conversion ratios. We wouldn't consider 1 liter or 1,000 mils to either of them have sig figs. But I think every teacher kind of does it on their own. So if you're taking a test and you don't remember what your teacher said, and you see some kind of word written out, you can definitely ask them. That's fair game. There's not one standard way that everyone should be doing that. That's all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed this longer, very detailed explanation of how to convert units. Again, I really think that if you struggle with this topic, this is the way that makes you think about every step that doesn't allow you to have a pitfall where you take a wrong turn. This is really the way that forces you to do it correctly, even though it takes longer. But hey, wouldn't you rather take longer and get the answer right than do a shortcut you don't understand and not know if you got it right? This is the teacher nagging side of me coming out. I can't control. It happens to everybody that starts teaching chemistry, I think. Anyway, that's all I have for you today. I hope you enjoy this video, and have a good day. Bye-bye.